Hello everybody, it's me, the Italian Gamer Joe, and welcome to another stream. Before we get started though, I'm just gonna really quickly check to see if I'm live, because I'm not sure if I'm live yet. Am I live? I'm using a new software called Gamecaster, and I'm seeing if this is working, so just bear with me while I check to see if I'm live and see if this is working, because if it's not, then I need to change this. Okay, it says I'm live. Okay, perfect, perfect. Okay, so the game that I'm playing tonight is called Delaware St. John. And Delaware St. John is a game that came out many, many years ago, and it took me a long time to get this to work on Windows. I actually was having stream problems, because you can't use Streamlabs OBS for this game. I use a third party called Gamecaster for this. And before we get started, I'm going to really quickly just share my stream in my Discord. And one moment as I do that real quick. Streaming a new mystery. Streaming Nancy Drew, and then I'll say, oh wait, we got a new detective in town. And his name is D-E-L-A-W-A-R-E, St. John. Come and check out a new, scary, creepy, spooky mystery with me. We'll go ahead and send it now. And then I'm going to go ahead and share it in my LGBT group. And then I'm going to share it in the adventure game group that I'm in. Okay, cool. Alright, and then let me just go ahead and jump into, Alright, cool. Well, let's get started. I'm excited, and also, let's just jump in. So this is Delaware St. John, Volume 1, The Curse of Midnight Manor. Ooh, spooky. Let's jump in. So there's two stories. There's the Fate of the Vandals and Done with Mirrors. So we're gonna do the first story, and see where it takes us. My face is covering up the man. This is so creepy. What the hell is going on?
Delaware, please!
You know, for a game that came out such a long time ago, this is really spooky.
That's how it always starts. Always the same, strange voices from beyond. Without warning, I find myself the recipient of desperate calls for help. The thing that makes these calls unique is that they don't come from the living. Ever since I was a child, I would hear the voices, louder and more desperate as I grew older, until I could figure out how to help them. Of course, this gift I have has made it near impossible for any kind of normal life. At least, that's what I thought until a chance meeting with Kelly Bradford. She ran a bookstore downtown. But on the side, she'd been doing paranormal investigation for paying clients. So we decided to team up. Things were going well until about a month ago when I began having the same nightmare over and over. It became louder, more vicious each time, until I couldn't take it anymore. Something powerful called to me and I had to go. My name is Delaware St. John, and this is the curse of Midnight Manor.
Wow, that was kind of spooky. So he's a paranormal investigator. And I guess he's going to this manor? I guess this manor still looks really creepy. I'm not looking forward to this. You know, it's kind of cool, though, seeing, like, games like this that have, like, Nancy Drew vibes, because this is the kind of game that does it, that basically, it has very similar vibes to Nancy Drew. Back when I played this game back in the day, I remember playing this and thinking to myself, like, this reminds me so much of Nancy Drew. Like, whoever made this game needs to get in touch with her interactive, and they need to do a collab together on Nancy Drew, Delaware St. John collab or something, because this game is something. It's definitely something. And it's cool, like, seeing what's going on in this game, and it's cool seeing, like, what, don't know. I'm just very, very surprised by the content in this game and the mystery itself. And it's been a hot minute since I played it. And one thing I will say is that in this game, it is possible to get game overs. So just like Nancy Drew, I guess. So we'll see how it goes. I'm kind of like... I'm excited, but I'm also a little scared. This is kind of like a... It's basically like a point-and-click horror game. Think of it as a point-and-click horror mystery game. And it's really good, but also, like, really scary. This game has very scary vibes to it. Okay. I think the game's just going to do that first, and then it's going to take us right to the manor. We're at a black screen right now. There we go.
Well, look who snuck out on another midnight adventure.
Kelly, how do you know I was out?
The device you're holding, the one I replaced your cell phone with yesterday, is a state-of-the-art voice imagery communicator. I call it Vic.
Oh my gosh,
it takes pictures, records sound, and even has a tracking device. I tell ya, you can find anything on online auctions these days.
This game is already scaring me.
From the signal I'm picking up, it looks like you're just outside of Morrisville.
I'm in an old building. Looks like it's been closed for years.
Morrisville Manor, or as the locals refer to it, Midnight Manor. The place has a pretty dark past.
You mean my nightmares didn't lead me to the land of candy cane?
1892 by a wealthy businessman named Bernard Armand. It was once considered a high-class resort until a series of tragedies caused rumors of a curse. Business died and the manor was closed for good. I'll do some research to get more details.
Good idea. I wonder where the light switch is around here.
For once, your sarcasm paid off. According to an old schematic I found online, there's an emergency generator in the basement. If you got that going, it would help you get around better than that flashlight.
Good thing, too. It seems to be running low on batteries.
Not prepared in the field again, Delaware? I'm so surprised.
So the game starts, and we're able to now look around. If we use the record mode, the photo mode, think of it like a Phasmophobia, where like you can do some stuff. But yeah, let's look around. So it's pitch black dark in this game, and we're basically stuck in this, like...
It's raining.
Okay, so there's a ghost right there. Like, that's a legit ghost.
He went to bed with a bump on the head and didn't get up in the morning.
Okay, that was creepy. And like I said, this game is a point-and-click adventure, just like Nancy Drew. This is the lobby that we're in. You can't go there yet. That's the exit, I think. Those are windows. This manor is so decrepit. Like, what the hell happened to it? Like, what is going on here? If we go backwards, that's the other exit. But we can't really do anything yet or go that way yet. Let's go forward for now. Oh, we can't go forward either. So right now I'm just trying to explore a little bit. I'm trying to get like my bearings together. I'm trying to figure out like which is the right way to go, and like, yeah, this is... Can we go this way? Okay, we can go this way. This game feels more scary than Phasmophobia. Oh my gosh, the game is taking us to the basement. It's taking us to the basement. Oh my god. We're in the basement of an abandoned manor. Oh my gosh, my flashlight went... Oh! My flashlight almost went off. This is not good. And you know the reason why a flashlight will start flickering. You know the reason. Oh my god. This is spooky. Look at all the old furniture. This is spooky. I don't like this. Why am I playing this? Oh my gosh. Where do we even go? I don't even know where to go. Like, this is... Oh my gosh. I'm in the basement. I'm stuck in the basement. I don't know where to go. I don't know what the right way to go is. This is so spooky. Okay, that's the stairway that leads to the exit. So at least we know where the exit is. Oh my gosh. And this music is just really, really messed up. Like, I'm not liking this music. Oh. Oh my gosh. This
disappearing
game.
People, check. Voices from beyond, check. I think this place just might be haunted.
Imagine going into an abandoned mansion and seeing a chair move on its own across the room. Like, that is a next level. Nancy Drew needs to take notes from this. The chair's not even in the room anymore. Oh my gosh. What's over there? Oh, some boots.
Fishing boots. Stylish and practical. I'll just
slip
these on.
We need boots, so yes, we're gonna take the boots. Where do we go, though? Like, this is... Oh, I saw a door here. Yeah, let's go to the door. Is that water? Oh my gosh. Just when you think it can't get any worse, now we have water. Okay, this looks like a box. Can we open it? Our new backup generator is all ready to go. To make sure that the new hire Ben doesn't mess with it, I put a lock code on it. I'm not good at remembering combinations, so I'm gonna write it here, but in code, so only I know how to unlock it. 8 marbles, 2 candles, 3 flowers, 6 beans, lined up backwards. And of course I don't have my journal on me. I'm taking a picture of it. Okay. Let's go back. Okay, let's go back for a second. Is there anything else we can do here? There's a generator here. Okay, so it's 8 marbles, 2 candles, 3 flowers, 6 beans lined up backwards. So I'm thinking it's 6, 3, 2, 8. 6, 6, 3, 3, 2, 2, 8. Okay.
Oh, sure, I can see the future, but I can't see when my flashlight will go out? That's fair.
Oh my gosh, did the generator turn on? Oh, good, the generator turned on. Okay, good. Okay, so we got the generator back on and running. So now we can actually see things. Okay, good. Can we save the game? Yeah, I want to save the game. I love the theme song, by the way. The theme song goes so hard. Okay. So here we are. This basement seems even more creepy now that the lights are on. When it was dark, like, it was creepy, but for some reason, this basement seems even more creepy.
It's a trunk. It looks like it's been down here a long time.
Oh, this game. We can't open it. Okay, so let's see. What can we do? Can we go forward? Look how big this room is.
Wow. Looks like it's time for a garage sale.
Like, this area is so big. There was a box over there. I want to go see what's in that box. Yeah, what's over there? What are you?
It's a keepsake box. It's locked.
Oh, do you know what that means? That means we're going to have to come back down here. I don't want to come back down here.
The door's locked.
Can we kick it down? This game scares the crap out of me. Oh my gosh. What are we gonna do? Can we use the elevator? No? Okay. Let's go back up the stairs. I'm done being in this basement. This basement creeps the frick out of me. Alright, let's do this.
Man, look at this place.
Mark, wait up.
Hey,
Bice.
We
should all stay together.
What? Are you scared?
Man, this place is totally rad to party in.
Yeah, it's all to ourselves.
Everyone says this place is haunted.
Don't worry. If we see any ghosts, Heather will put a voodoo spell on them.
Funny, but I think your body odor will keep ghosts far away.
Man, Lisa, why did the little goth girl have to tag along?
Because that goth girl is my best friend, so watch it or I'll leave with her.
Let's go look around.
That was creepy. I like the room lighting. Thank you. So we're playing a game called Delaware St. John, and Delaware St. John is a game about a detective. He's a paranormal detective. And we are in Morrisville Manor, and it's this decrepit place, and John is having like nightmares, and in the nightmares they are telling him to come to the manor to help them. to help the people in the nightmares are telling him to come to Morrisville Manor. And we don't know why they're asking him to come to Morrisville Manor, but they're asking him to come to Morrisville Manor. And it's kind of creepy and it's kind of messed up. And we just had to turn the power on in this place because the power was out. And now we're seeing like ghosts. We're seeing like creepy, disturbing ghosts. And the ghosts decided that they wanted to go give the place a look around. And we don't know where they went or what they did. But all we know is that there were some ghosts here that are giving the place a look around. And if they're ghosts, that can only mean one thing. That they died. So that's really creepy. Oh, we can go in here. This is creepy.
Man, what a dump. Reminds me of my old apartment.
Well, now we know the case is solved. Delaware St. John is a snob. No, not a snob, a slob. Let it be heard. Oh my gosh. This is so creepy.
So, what can I get you, little lady?
Oh my gosh.
Oh, I think I'm pretty set here with my flask.
Gotta admire a woman who's prepared. Give me some of that.
Brendan!
Uh-oh.
Melissa! Help! You guys! Come here!
What is going on with her? That was creepy. She's like choking. Was it something she drank?
This earring is only a few months old, and whoever owned it is still around here.
Oh, jeez. That's scary. So that means the earring, whoever owns the earring might still be here, alive or dead. I like the music. The jazz is really cool, by the way. Boys rule. That's so cheesy.
This ladder could come in handy.
We picked up a ladder. Let's go up these stairs. Is there anything we can see up here? This game is so creepy.
The door's locked.
Damn it, the door's locked. You know what, though? We need that ladder. Maybe we can use the ladder to go upstairs or something. Because I think the stairs are, like, kind of messed up. So let's go this way. Oh, this game is so creepy. Oh, Kelly,
you know,
our partner's
Delaware,
calling us.
I'm just going to come out and say it. I'm not too thrilled about you going out there alone. We're supposed to be a
team, Josh.
And you took off without me.
Yeah, I guess I forgot to call. But it was really late. Next time, okay? I need you to do me a favor.
Of course you do.
I'm seeing things. People. Can you run a check on missing persons in the last few months around here?
Missing persons. Got it. Anything else?
That's it for now. I'm going to look around more.
I'm gonna move my camera here so you guys can see me a little bit better, I think. Okay. So yeah, what we're trying to do is that we're trying to figure out where these ghosts are going and what they're doing, and it's really creepy. Like, this is so creepy. Can we go this way? Oh, okay. No, we already went that way. Okay, can we go this way? Yeah, we can go this way. So
this stairwell leads to the first floor, but the bottom steps have rotted out.
So we went to the basement, but we have the ladder, so we can use the ladder now to help us go up to the second floor. So here we are on the second floor.
The elevator's not working.
So let's go ahead and look around on the second floor. This manor looks like a hotel.
Calm down, Brendan. What happened?
I don't know. We were just talking. She just passed out. I didn't do nothing.
Passed out? Here, put her on the bed. She's so cold.
She was fine 1 minute, and then she was on the floor. I called, but no one came. I figured you guys were up here.
We need to get her to a hospital. Where's Mark and Lisa? Are they still in the basement?
I don't know. I didn't see them. I'm gonna go downstairs and look for them.
Brendan, where are you going?
That's scary.
We should take Melissa with us. Melissa? Brendan, Melissa's gone!
How does a person just disappear like that? Where can you get this game? So you can get this game on Big Fish Games. You can get it on Big Fish Games. Okay, so apparently Melissa was gone, but where is she? This hallway is so creepy. Did I save? Okay, I saved. I love the theme song, by the way. Okay, room 109.
The door's locked.
A lot of these doors are locked. Oh, okay. Let's see. Can we go to that room? That's open. Oh my gosh, look at the bed. Is that where Melissa was?
I wonder what this dark area is. It looks like a person was laying here. The dark area looks like it was burned.
Oh my god, was Melissa burned alive or was she... Oh my god, look, there's the earring.
It's another earring, like the one I found downstairs.
What can we do with it? Can we pair him up or something?
Thank you.
Oh my god, that was creepy. Melissa just thanked us. Okay, that was not cool. That was scary.
Normally, it'd be rude reading someone's private thoughts, but given the circumstances, I think it's okay this one time.
So we found a diary. This journal is the property of Heather Malcolm, so hands off. Oh my gosh. So here we are at the place they call Midnight Manor. Mark insisted this would be a wicked place to crash, but this place is creepy. Aunt Caroline has warned me over and over that this place is haunted, but she also says ghosts can't harm the living. Mark calls me a wannabe goth chick for talking about these spirits that supposedly live here, but the fact is, no one knows what happened to all those people years ago. It kind of feels like part of them is still around here, like we're being watched from behind the walls. It's a very strange sensation. If it weren't for Lisa, I'd just bail now, but I couldn't leave her with Mark. He's a jerk. I know Mark only brought her here to get her to cling to him more. Disgusting. Speaking of, I'm gonna go check out the basement. Mark and Lisa are down there looking through the old junk that's still here. Maybe they found something cool. So it looks like the diary is instructing us to go to the basement. So we better go do that.
The door's locked.
Wait, that's not the door we came in from. Like, getting... freaky on me. This Gamecaster software is not the best when it comes to switching between windows.
Hey, Del.
I have never played
going?
Darkfall the Journal. What's Darkfall
here.
The Journal?
We got furniture moving by itself, voices in the dark, and something I've never seen before.
Like?
A silhouette. A dark outline on this bed. It was like the body was still there, but you couldn't see it. When I placed an earring I found next to the matching one, the dark outline just vanished.
An outline? Sounds like energy.
Oh, it's ghost
transition.
Hunting? That sounds cool.
Sometimes, in cases of an unexpected or untimely death, spirits will return to the scene of death until someone discovers them. Then, once they've been discovered, they inhabit their bodies one last time, before transitioning from the physical world to the spiritual world.
Like they're getting a sense of closure.
Sure. But in those cases, there's a body, not an outline. I'm going to have to look more into this.
Okay. So, how are we doing on the missing persons?
I'm still checking a few things out. I've got a lead, but nothing solid yet. I'll give you a buzz when I have something more.
You got my number.
So apparently, if a ghost hasn't had closure yet, they can't move on. And when they finally move on, they inhabit their bodies one more time before transferring themselves over to the spiritual world. So... But Kelly, our partner, is saying that that's not the case, and that there might be something more sinister going on. What the hell was that? Okay, I'm saving. This game is so scary. I just heard, like, thumping noises. And I don't remember how we got here. I'm just waiting for, like, some thing that'll just pop out and scare the crap out of me. I know, that knocking was not me or my room. That was the game.
I've heard of being a pack rat, but this is crazy. I'm not going to be able to get past this mess.
Something was knocking. This game is so creepy. So we're going to have to go to the basement again, and I really don't like going to the basement because the basement is scary as hell. Alright, look how dark the basement is. I hate the basement. This is the least favorite part of the game. I hate the basement. Oh, there they are on the corner.
Look at all this cool junk.
Maybe we'll find something cool.
This stuff has been here forever. We're not gonna find anything we can use.
Okay, that was scary. So let's go by them and see if there was anything over there.
Hey, I think someone just went in that room over there. Maybe it's a ghost.
Don't scare me like that. You know how I can get my... Oh my god!
Okay, so she screamed, and then something happened. Can we open this box
yet? It's a keepsake box. It's locked.
Okay, so the box is still locked. Let's go to the door and see if we can open it.
Delaware!
Jeez, Kelly, you scared me.
Someone's a little
I don't know
heavy.
What scratches is,
Nothing
but it sounds scary.
Taking the batteries out of this thing won't fix.
Don't you dare. Okay, check this out. Last month, 5 teens were reported missing.
Police said Scream the kids slightly told their parents
they were going to a party and then just never came back.
Got any names?
Yeah. Heather Malcolm,
17. Oh my god, these are the
Lisa
same
Kelly,
names
of
the teens that we keep
Mark
seeing
Johnson,
in our visions.
18, his younger sister, Melissa,
this is
17,
scary.
And also a Brendan Michaels, 18.
Well, we can scratch them off the missing persons list.
You found them?
I found Heather Malcolm's journal upstairs.
They were there? Any idea what happened to them?
I'm still working on that. I think the dark outlines I found are important. I just don't know what they mean yet. It would help if every door wasn't locked.
Well, for every lock, there's a key.
True. But this particular door doesn't look very sturdy.
Delaware St. John, you better not break that door.
Sorry, Kelly, you're breaking up.
So we can break down doors.
Here goes nothing.
Because Delaware has muscles. He's a muscular guy, so we can break down doors. This looks like a laundry room. Yeah, this is a laundry room. Can we do anything back here? I don't see... Oh, there's two... What happened? What is going on? So we saw a vision of a plant. I wonder if those were the bodies of the dead that... of the two characters we saw, and they got... maybe they got stuck in the basement somewhere. The game is making us go somewhere else, though. So, I'm gonna save. This game is so freaking scary. I don't even know where to go next. This game is creeping me out. Is this where the exit is? Yeah. So, there was a plant that it wants us to go find, but I have no idea where the plant is. That's not it. I think the plant was upstairs. But we can't go upstairs that way. We have to go upstairs this way. Yeah, this way. Is the plant somewhere over here? No, that's the exit. So we're trying to find a plant. Okay, that's just a room. Was the plant in the bedroom? I'm double checking the bedroom. I don't think it was. Yeah, it wasn't. Okay.
The door's locked.
I always pick the wrong door on accident. Okay. So if the plant wasn't there, then where could this plant be? Wait a minute. There's footsteps on the floor. Could it be that the game wants us to go this way? Maybe not. Maybe I'm just crazy. I'm crazy. Okay. Well, we can't go upstairs anymore. This plant has to be around here somewhere. Is it upstairs? Yeah, it is! Wait. Let's go back for a second. No, not that way. Wait, I saw... That's the plant we needed. Yeah. This is it.
There was a key in the dirt. It's to room 104.
So apparently we need to go to room 104. Alright, well, let's make our way to room 104. Can we go up this way? To the stairs?
The door's locked.
Okay, the door's locked. So we can't go that way. Is the door locked here, too?
The door's locked.
Okay, so all of those doors are locked for now. So let's go up the ladder and do it that way instead. What the hell? It's coming for you. Don't
it's
look at it.
It's coming for you.
What's coming for us? Don't look at it. Run to... What the hell? Okay, well, something is chasing us. And we need to hurry to room 104. Oh my god. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Is room 104 this way? I forgot if room 104 is this way. There's 104. Oh my gosh. It's in the hallway! Ah! Okay, run 104. Use the key. Open it. Oh my god. Delaware, open it! Oh my god. Oh my gosh. That was scary. Something is trying to take the door down.
Del, are you there? I wasn't getting a signal.
Yeah, I'm here. Barely. There's something here, Kelly.
Well, yeah, that's
That was not cool.
No, I mean
that
something actually chased me. Like, a dark cat-like figure. I got a warning to hide in a room, and the next thing I know, this thing is chasing me.
A totally free-form mobile apparition? And it chased you?
You know, if I didn't know any better, I'd think you were thrilled some hell beast just stalked me down the halls.
No, no, of course not. You're all right, right?
As good as I can be. It just...
So what did it look like? Did you get a picture?
Let's try this again. Kelly, a monster just came out of the basement and chased me, trying to kill me. And you want to know if I asked it to pose for a glamour shot?
Yes.
Well, whatever it is, it sounds like it only had enough energy to materialize for a short while. If it shows up again, just outrun it until it disappears again. I'll check a few books to see if I can find more details. Where are you now?
Room 104.
Well, get back to exploring.
This game literally just became Resident Evil.
Really be great.
Like, now we're going to have to deal with a with a monster that's gonna that we're going to have to run from. I don't see anything here. These rooms look the same. I don't see anything. Is there anything over here? Anything by the fireplace? Want to become famous? Buy followers and viewers. I don't want to buy followers and viewers. I want them to be natural. I want people to watch me for me. You can't buy that. Now, sachet.
The door's locked.
Okay, let's see. Ooh.
You can't see me here. 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 You can't.
That was scary.
Okay, Heather. What else has been going on?
It was a big mistake to come here. Aunt Caroline was right about this place. Brendan bought Melissa up to the room. She was unconscious. I told him we needed to get her out of here, to the hospital, but he was screaming about the doors not opening. He ran from room, just leaving Melissa on the bed. I started to follow Brendan, but finally had to stop because I couldn't catch him. When I came back into the room, Melissa wasn't even on the bed. In her place was a dark shadow where she had been. Right now I'm waiting here in room 104. I went to the basement earlier to find Lisa and Mark, but they weren't down there. I'm hoping this is just another one of Mark's pranks. They're in bad taste, but I'd rather think it that than any other possibilities for what's going on here. Well, that didn't really exactly give us a tip for what to do next. See you, Josh. Wait, what the hell's going on?
Is it me? Or wasn't there an end to this hallway before?
Oh my gosh. The hallway isn't ending. Oh my gosh. The hallway. Right up. Okay. So right. Am I gonna get spooked? Oh, I got it like reset on me. Time to cry, I know, right? Right up. This is scary. Okay, so right. It's like a maze in a hallway. Okay, right. God, that whispering is so creepy. And then we're gonna go up. Now what? Okay, now she's making us go into a room. This is so scary. Oh my God. What is with that noise? This is so scary. Oh my God, I'm ready to be jump scared right now. Wait, we're back in the hallway though. She's laughing. Oh my God, there's more. There's more. Okay, I need something to write with because this is too much. This is too much for the Italian gamer Joe. Okay, so we need to do. Wait, did it time out? Okay, up, left, left, right, up. Okay, up, left, left, right, up. Up. Okay, so we're going up first. And then left. And then left again. And then right this time. And then up. Okay, did we do it? I think we did it. And now she wants us to go through a different room. Okay, let's go through that room. This is so scary. Okay, now what? Is it like 16 symbols or something? Oh my God, there's so many! Left, right, up, up, right, right, left, up. Okay, let's do it. I think I fucked it up. Okay, left first. And then right. And then up again. Then up one more time. And then right. Right again. And then left. And then up. Did that do it? It did it. Okay. And now she's going through the left door again. This is so creepy. Like, this is, like, scarier than Nancy Drew. I'm so scared. Oh, we're back. Oh my God, we're back. I'm gonna save the game because that scared me. That scared the crap out of me. We did it, everybody. We did it. Oh, look at the girl on the right.
What are
on the right.
You doing?
I'm making something that should protect us.
This isn't time for arts and crafts or your voodoo talk. We need to figure a way out.
It will help us.
The doors won't open. They're not locked or nothing. They just won't open. What's going on in this place? Where's Lisa and Mark?
Brendan, pull yourself together.
Oh, man. I'll bet this is one of Mark's jokes. Yeah. I'll bet he's hiding with Melissa and Lisa right now. Yeah. I'm gonna go find them.
Brendan, look. Let me get this ornament together and we'll... Brendan? Brendan, where are you?
This is so scary.
Another journal page.
Oh, geez, another journal page. As I sit here writing, I can feel a cold draft blow across the back of my neck. When I look up, I see something. It's the outline of a woman standing in front of the door to the lobby. She smiles lovingly with both arms across her chest, but when I look closer, I can see a bloody cleaver in one hand. I know from working at Aunt Caroline's shop that I'm seeing a projection from the past. It's harmless, but that doesn't make it any less disturbing. I read that an image of a person with their arms crossed at the chest suggests they don't want you to leave, that there's unfinished business. All the windows in the lobby are too high to reach, and the doors to the outside are stuck shut. It's like something's blocking them shut. Everyone is gone, just me and Brendan left. We never should have come here. Even though my watch says it's 7 a.m., it's still dark as midnight outside. Something evil here doesn't want us to leave. Oh my god, this is fucked up. This is scary. You can find this game on Big Fish Games. What the hell? This game is screwed up. Well, we know there's an ornament that we can find, I guess. But can we go in here? Is there something we can do in here? At this point, I have no idea where to go, so I'm just kind of exploring a little bit.
Man, what a dump. Reminds me of my old apartment.
But we do know that there's a charm or something somewhere because we could find. So, oh my gosh, the chair just put itself back together.
It's the last page in Heather's journal.
Oh my gosh, it's a page. Brendan and I thought that sticking together would be the best idea. When I turned around, he was gone. No sound or anything. Just gone. My watch stopped working a while ago. I think it's about 9 a.m. outside. It's still pitch black. Aunt Caroline wasn't right about ghosts. They can harm the living. I started getting bitten and scratched a little while ago, so I put together a crude protection ornament to ward off the dark spirits. It worked so far, but I can feel the energy is growing here, and it's only a matter of time before my charm won't stand up against them. If something doesn't happen to me, I can only hope someone finds my journal so they can know what is happening here. I'm going to move into the lounge since the lobby activity seems to be increasing. I'm sorry I ever came here. I just want to go home. That's fucked up. And there's the charm.
This is strange. Like a little homemade doll. I wonder if Kelly knows what it is.
Can we take a picture of it?
Kelly, take a look at this. Can you tell me what it is?
1 second. The image is coming up. Yeah. It's a dispel charm. It arms the carrier with the ability to repel evil spirits. You just need to hold it up to any spirits that get too close to you.
Well, we're taking it. Oh, the chair fell apart. I'm gonna save just in case. Oh my god. Oh, is this person up there? Oh my gosh. And they left. Oh my god. Use the charm. Oh my god. There's ghosts appearing. Oh my god. And they have weapons! This is turning into Resident Evil! Oh my god. This is scary. Now I'm like playing a Resident Evil. I feel like I'm playing like whack-a-mole for ghosts. Whack. You get a whack. Oh my god. You get a whack. Ah! That startled me. Who needs to play Dead by Daylight when you can just play Delaware St. John? Hi, Candy Girl. Oh my god, this is so scary! This is creepy. Oh my god. Oh my god. How many people died here? Oh my gosh. They're trying to get up here. Push them, Delaware, push them. Oh my god. They're coming. How many are there? This is so creepy. They're outside. The chef. So many! Oh my god. Is there any more? I'm like scared to put it away. That was scary.
There's a shadow on the floor, but when I touch it, it doesn't vanish like the others.
Oh yeah, the shadow of a dead body. That's scary.
There's a shadow on the floor. But when I touch it, it doesn't vanish like the others.
Maybe I have to put, like, a book on it?
Thank you.
Oh, it was Heather's book. Oh.
You never quite know what's going to be asked of you in this line of work. Heather and her friends were only looking to be found, released from their anonymous graves. As they passed on through the night, I couldn't help but get the sense that this incident was not why I was here. Something much more disastrous happened here. I could tell my night was just beginning.
Wow. That was messed up. Holy crap. Congratulations, you completed Story 1, The Fate of Vandals, and unlocked Story 2, Done with Mirrors. To play Story 2, select New Game from the main menu and choose Story 2. Oh my god. That was messed up. Well, now we can do Story 2. Done with Mirrors. Let's check it out. Audience talking. Can I do anything? Oh, they're all like waiting for a show to start.
Ladies and gentlemen, the moment you've all been waiting for. The world-famous Rupert Cosmont will now perform the death-defying human pincushion act. Quietly.
Death-defying human pincushion act? Oh my god.
One wrong move, and it could be curtains for Rupert.
That's not that scary. Oh my god. And it just appeared. Oh my god, he died.
He's dead!
Oh my god. So she killed him.
Who did this to me?
So apparently a magician in this place died. That was scary. Can we go upstage? We can.
An advertisement for an old magic act. For some reason, looking at it is making me uneasy.
The Marvelous Rupert Cosmont. And then it's a contact, and then it shows all his tricks. Where are they?
An advertisement for an old magic act. For some reason, looking at it is making me uneasy.
So apparently he died from his own magic trick. It's messed up. Can we do anything back here, or is there anything else we can do back here? No? I'm gonna save, though, real quick. Continue game. Okay. Hydrate. So for hydration tonight, I just have some Ice Mountain water. Brought to you by Ice Mountain. This is not a sponsorship. Okay, so for those of you that are just arriving and just hanging out, if you're new, welcome. I'm the Italian Gamer Joe. If you're just returning, I'm playing a game that's similar to Nancy Drew. It's called Delaware St. John. I will repeat it again. It's called Delaware St. John. You can only find this game on Big Fish Games. You can only find this game on Big Fish Games. I'm not streaming with OBS. I'm streaming with a different software called Gamecaster because Gamecaster works with old PC games. This game came out eons ago, and I will bet you all that Nancy Drew will probably be easier for me to stream now that I can stream with this software. So I'm going to try it out, and hopefully I'll be able to stream a lot better with this game, this software, if I ever have to stream adventure games. But anyway, the premise of this game is that you play as Delaware St. John. His name is John, and he's a paranormal investigator. And I guess, like, he had nightmares of people that were, like, struggling, and they were calling for help. And they brought him this hotel.
The door's locked.
And he found out that a bunch of teenagers broke into the hotel and they died here. And Deller found their bodies. And he had to do like some things to help them like move on. It's really spooky. And he was able to do it, but now I guess there's a magician here that also needs to move on, and we need to help the magician move on from to the afterlife. But we still have no idea how to do it. And that's going to be the next quest, I'm guessing. Trying to figure out, like, how to help the magician. So, what I'm trying to do right now is just look around and see if there's, like, anything I can do to figure something out. I might have to call Kelly. So, Kelly is our in-game, like partner. Let's connect with her and see if we can do it.
I'm just getting started. No need to call Kelly. I should check around the stage.
Okay, so Delaware wants us to check around the stage, which is actually really helpful, because that trying to figure out what to do next is kind of like part of it, I guess. Okay. Well, we did this.
An advertisement for an old magic act. For some reason, looking at it is making me uneasy.
Is there anything else we can do here? Can we take a picture of it?
Hey, Kelly.
Yeah,
check this out. It's an old poster from Rupert's magic act. Do you suppose it's been here all these years?
Hey, Del. I thought you said you found one of Rupert's old posters. I have the photo here, but all I see is a newspaper article on a corkboard.
Wait, what? A newspaper article? Wait, what? Oh my god, that's so crazy! Oh my god! We took the picture, and it only came across as a newspaper. How messed up is that?
A vintage
fatal
newspaper
accident.
Article. This looks like something Kelly would love.
Oh my god. Morrisville County police investigators were called to Morrisville Manor last night to investigate the mysterious death of renowned magician Rupert Cosmont, 35 years old. Witnesses say that Cosmont was performing one of his shows last night at the local hotel when one of his tricks went terribly wrong. He got into a box and his assistant started sliding swords into it. Like an illusion you'd see at an old magic show, said one dramatic witness, Rihanna Vandersnatch. But according to a police and other witness testimony, when Cosmont's assistant, Faye Harris, opened the box up, Cosmont was dead with multiple lacerations to his body. You could see what looked like blood dripping from the box. We thought it was part of the trick. Then she opened it. People just started screaming and it became so chaotic, said another witness. After questioning Harris and other witnesses, Captain Aaron Jefferson of the Morrisville Police Department said there was no reason to suspect foul play and has ruled the death an accident. The trick just went bad, said Jefferson. There's no malicious intent. This is the second death to take place this week at Morrisville Manor. Earlier this week, the body of Roxanne Black, a Morrisville Manor maid, was discovered in the hotel stairwell, according to investigators. Black fell down two flights of stairs, breaking her neck. Her death was also ruled an accident. Jefferson said he could comment no further on the case. This is messed up.
A vintage newspaper article. This looks like something Kelly...
So that means that two people have died, according to this article. Can we take a picture of it for Kelly? No, you did. Okay.
Got the article, Delaware. Reading it now.
Anything strange to you?
Kind of. According to Faye Harris's testimony, they did the show as planned. She said she never heard him use their safe word to stop the trick. I searched for Faye Harris on the internet and found another article about her. Apparently, she was so distraught.
Oh my god, she killed herself the next day!
At the manor?
She and Rupert had been staying in room 204.
Did she kill herself by ingesting poison?
Poison, yeah. How did you know?
Lucky guess.
I guess that was a dumb question.
Well, I'm gonna go check out room 204 and see what I find. You got anything else?
I'm going to cross-reference that article with the accidental death of the maid Roxanne Black. It seems way too coincidental.
Is that Jenna Devlin's voice? I have no idea.
I'll look into it more and see what I can find. Go ahead and check out room 204. I'll get back to you when I get something.
I'll be here.
The game is called Delaware St. John, so you can look up the first. This is the first game. So you're welcome to look into it and see if it is. Because I don't think I can see the credits from here. All right, well, the second floor, I know we can get to the first floor easy. The second floor, I don't know. Is the elevator still broken?
The elevator doesn't seem to work down here. Guess I should try the stairs.
Okay, so we can't use the elevator. I guess I'll be using the stairs. But how do we get to the next floor? Can we use the elevator?
The elevator's not working. Maybe Kelly knows something. Oh, Kelly?
Yes?
Any idea how I can get this elevator to work on the first floor? There's power, but it's not working.
According to the blueprints, there's some sort of lock on the elevator.
That's good to know.
It's a manual lock, probably for storage reasons. You're gonna have to go to the basement and unlock the brake by hand.
Right, the basement. Again.
Oh, you can do it. You're a big, strong man.
No, I'm not a big, strong man. I am not going to the basement. You can't make me! I hate going to the basement in this game. This basement creeps the hell out of me. This basement scares me. This is more scary than Phasmophobia, in my opinion. Like, this game just has so much unknown to it. Look at this. This is the way to the basement. Like, just pitch black. Pitch black. Oh my god, I hate going to this basement. It's so creepy. Oh my god.
Don't be afraid. I'm here to help you.
Oh my god.
Can you tell me your name?
Katie, what's yours?
My name's Delaware.
Oh my god.
That's a funny name.
Oh my god.
So I've heard. Can you tell me, Katie?
I have to go.
No, come back. That was messed up. Where'd she go? Oh my god, this game is so creepy. Yeah, if you're looking for a Nancy Drew game that's, like, similar to Nancy Drew, check out Delaware St. John. You can find these games on Big Fish Games.
It's a trunk. It looks like it's been down here a long time.
This is so creepy. Oh my god. Can we open... Oh, we need the key for that still. Can we go in the laundry room? Is she in there? No? Okay. I know that we're trying to fix the elevator, but let's see. I know that there's a generator somewhere. Yeah, over here. This game is really messed up. Like, really messed up. Maybe the... Okay, it's not... It's not happening there. I can hear sounds. Can you record the sound of the... I don't know if that's going to do anything, but...
Hey, Del. I just had my PC analyze that recording you sent me.
Nothing.
I didn't pick up anything unusual.
But I hear dropping. What's the dropping sounds? You're... I can hear it. Oh my gosh, I keep hearing it. Okay, well, we can't do anything here. What's that sound, though? I see... Is that the elevator? Like, am I just, like, missing the elevator hotspot? Oh, wait. What's this? Ben will never figure out the 3-digit code that unlocks the elevator. I don't want that boy unlocking the elevator after I locked it up for the night. I'm putting the code in a code. Ben thinks I hate him. I hate Ben. I hate him. Handyman Frank. 24312. Ben thinks I hate him. I hate Ben. I hate him. Oh! I got it. So I is 3. Hate is 1. Ben is 2. I is 3. Hate is 1. 2. It's 312, 312.
3. 1. 2. That's not it.
Wait, what? It's 312312, I thought. It's a 3-digit code. Ben will never figure out the 3-digit code that unlocks the elevator. I don't want that boy unlocking the elevator after I locked it up for the night. Ben thinks I hate him. I hate Ben. I hate him. Well, I is 3. Hate is 1. Ben is 2. I is 3. Oh, I hate Ben. I hate him. So 3-1. 3-1-2. 3-1-2. Ben and him are shared. They both have twos. Unless it's flipped. It could be I is... 3. No, I is... No, I'm sorry. Ben thinks I hate him. I hate Ben. I hate him. Because I was thinking that 2 is Ben, 4 is thinks, 3 is I, hate is 1, and 2 is him. But there's 2 twos. I hate Ben. I hate him. So, what I was thinking was, Ben and him are both 2. Two, 4, 3, 1, 2. I'm thinking. Unless it's supposed to be a 7, but they both look the same. Ben thinks I hate him. I hate Ben. I hate him. Ben thinks I hate him. I hate Ben. I hate him. Ben thinks I hate him. So like, if that were the case, then maybe Ben would be 3. Thinks wouldn't make sense. Ben thinks I hate him. I is 3. Hate is 1. Ben is 2. I is 3. I'll try it again.
3. 1. 2. That's not it.
Ben thinks I hate him. Is it a code then? Like, is that the code? Because it's I hate Ben, I hate him. So I'm thinking it's 3-1 something, 3-1 something. And Ben and him are both 2. So my thinking is, why would there be 2 2s? In the same code sequence. No. Doesn't make sense, though. I don't understand what to do here. Because there's 2 2s. And that means 2 stands for Ben, and 2 stands for... Yeah, I was thinking 2 plus 2 is 4. So, like, 3, 1, 4... Can try it.
3, 1, 4. That's not it.
Yeah. Ben thinks I hate him. I hate Ben. I hate. I mean, does it make sense? Because the 2 is pairing up with the 1 with Ben. Thinks is 4. I is 3. Hate is 1. Him is 2. Right. Because it's 6 words, 6 numbers, and then 6 words below it. Wait. There's 2 I's. So there's 2 I's, which means that it's a 3. So maybe like 3 plus 3 is 6. And then there's 2 hates. So that's 2. Because 1 plus 1 is 2. There's 1 Ben and 1 him. And I'm going to equate them to 4. For now. So I'm thinking it's 6 2 4, maybe?
6 2 4. That's not it.
Okay, if it's not 6 2 4, then my guess is that it's maybe 6 2. Wait. I and I is 1, so that's 2. Wait. I hate Ben, I hate him. So I is. So I'm thinking that's 2, my bad. Hate and hate is in there. Oh, wait a minute. I is 3. I'm sorry. It's 3. And then hate and hate is in there, so that's 2. And then Ben and him is both 2, but they're 2 different words. So I'm guessing it's 2. So I'm guessing it's 3, 2, 2.
3. 2. 2. That's not it.
Damn it! Ah! It's not 3, 2, 2.
3. 1. 2. That's not it.
Come on. Because I was thinking there's 2 I's. So I was thinking 3 plus 3 is 6. There's 2 hates. So 1 plus 1 is 2. And then Ben and him are the same. Because Ben is 2 and him is 2. So I was thinking 2 plus 2 is 4. But 6... Wait. There's 2 I's. So that's 6. Hate is 2. Yeah, 6, 2... Wait a minute, did I do 6, 2, 2? I don't think I did 6, 2, 2.
2, 2, that's not it.
Damn it, and it wasn't 3, 2, 2?
3, 2, 2, That's not it.
I can try 624 and 324.
3, 2, 4. That's not it. 6, 2, 4. That's not it.
Unless it's all of the entire letter. So Ben is 2, which means that it's all the Bens in the letter. Because that means it's 2 for the first Ben in the very top. It's 1, so it's 1, 2, 3. And 3 times 2 is 6. Because it's 1, 2, 3 times 2 is 6. And then thinks. There's only one thinks, so it's 4. Yeah, but that doesn't really make sense, does it? That doesn't really make sense, though, because then we're still getting a six-digit number. I hate Ben, I hate him. Well, for I, there's threes, so 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 12, though. That wouldn't make sense. I hate Ben, I hate him. Well, that was 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Which makes 6, 2, 4. This is so confusing. I'm putting the code in code. Ben thinks I hate him. I hate Ben. I hate him. 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. For hate again, and then 2. 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. I hate Ben, I hate him. 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. And him and Ben are both twos. 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. This is so confusing. Why am I struggling with this? Chat, do you have any suggestions? I don't know what to do. Ben will never figure out the 3-digit, D-I-D-G-I-T, that's spelled wrong. I'm putting the code in code. I think what I might do is end stream for tonight and revisit this tomorrow or Thursday, because I don't know what else to do. I'm past an hour for the stream, so I'm figuring, you know what, maybe I'll just do this again on Thursday. Ben thinks I hate him. I hate Ben. I hate him. Yeah, this is a toughie. I'm thinking I might just end stream for tonight and come back another time. Give this a few days to think about. Ben thinks I hate him. And I think 2 is Ben, 4 is thinks, I is 3, hate is 1, him is 2. But there's 2 twos in the sequence, in the code. So like, for I hate Ben, I hate him, that's 6 words. So why would they do that? This is a struggle. I'm very, very like lost in thought right now, 'cause I hate Ben. I hate him. I hate Ben. I hate him. That's 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 4. No, I'm sorry. 312, 312. Is it backwards? 213? I mean, did he make it backwards?
213?
That's not it.
This is so confusing. It's the hardest puzzle in the game. This is harder than any Nancy Drew puzzle. Oh my god. Ben thinks I hate him. I hate Ben. I hate him. I think I might have to end stream for tonight and come back in a few days. Come back on Thursday. And figure this out. Because I don't know. I'm trying to think what else to do here. I tried everything. I tried 312. I tried 624 by adding them together. I tried 322. I tried counting the number of times I see the words. This is a struggle. I'm lost. Oh man, this is quite a puzzle. I've tried everything. 2 for Ben. 24312. I hate him. 3, 1, 2, 3. I'm thinking, like, maybe is there a reason why the numbers are a certain way? There are 6 digits, but you were looking for 3. Exactly, candy girl. Ben will never figure out the 3-digit code that unlocks the elevator. Ben thinks I hate him. Unless, like, Ben for some reason equals 2 and thinks for some reason equals 4. 3 for some reason equals I. But like I don't know if that makes any sense. Try connecting with her.
Hey, Kelly, what room number was that again?
Room 204, Del.
Can you send her a picture?
I got the scan, Del. That handyman was kind of paranoid, huh? I think I got the solution. See if you can figure it out. Call me back if you want my suggestion.
So we technically can call Kelly if she wants us to figure it out. I'm kind of debating. I'm a little desperate here. Should we ask Kelly? I don't know if we should ask Kelly or not. Should we try to figure it out? This is intense. All right, I think I'm gonna give Kelly a call again.
Del, I got that last image you sent.
Oh, oops.
Scanners didn't pick up anything unusual. You should conserve the battery life of Vic by only taking pictures where you suspect paranormal activity is taking place.
Let's just call her.
Well, here it seems he just made a sentence with a numeric key.
That's what I thought, yeah.
The numbers attached to the letters are 312312.
That's what I did.
Now, since he says it's a 3-digit code, I figured out the 6 numbers are actually
coordinates.
If you look at the keypad, the coordinates lead to the numbers 3, 8, 4. Try those. I believe they'll work.
Wait, what? They're coordinates? 2, 4, 3, 1. 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Wait, what? Coordinates. 3, 1 equals first digit. 3, 1. 3, third column, first row. 2, 3. So 2, 3, which is 8. And then 1, 2, which is 4. Oh my god, they're coordinates. Oh my gosh, that was tough.
3, 8, 4. Oh my god. The elevator is in service.
I mean, I don't think I ever would have guessed that. That is some logic. Who would figure that out? I mean, I'm sure there's people out there that would. I mean, how do we figure out the Nancy Drew puzzles we figure out? That was intense. I mean, there's Nancy Drew puzzles that are way worse than that, but like, oh my god. Thanks, Candy Girl, for mapping out that solution with me. Alright, so now we're going to go back upstairs. Or I'm not going to end stream yet. We'll see this through and see if we can go to the elevator. Okay, let's go in. Alright, we're going to floor 2. This elevator feels so creepy. I don't like going through elevators. I'm saving just in case, because you can never know if you're going to die in this game. Okay, so we have to go to room 204. Are you 204? No, that's 211. Okay, let's make our way to 204. Can we record the crying?
Hey, Del. Had my PC analyze that recording you sent me. I didn't pick up anything unusual.
Well, there's 204.
The door's locked.
Wait, what?
Hey, Kelly, what room was that again?
Room 204, Delaware. Do you need me to write it down for you?
No, I got it this time. The door's locked.
Am I crazy? That is 204. 205, yeah.
Hello, Katie. What's wrong?
Oh, it's a kid.
It's Arthur.
Arthur?
My bunny rabbit. A big cat broke him. Can you help me find the rest of him and fix him?
A big cat, huh? I'll fix him for you.
Okay, so apparently her stuffed animal broke. And there's 2 pieces we have to find. The first piece looks like the basement? Yeah, that's the basement. And then where's the second piece? So it only gave us 1 location. Alright, looks like we're gonna have to go to the basement again. I'm not looking forward to that. This game loves to bring us to the basement. Loves it! Alright, everybody, I've way past the hour mark, so I'm gonna end stream for tonight. For those of you that are here, thank you for tuning in to watch me play St. Delaware, St. John. Just so you know, you can play this game on bigfishgames.com. I will be back to continue solving this case on Thursday. So tomorrow will be the finale of Nancy Drew Final Scene, and then Thursday will be Delaware St. John. We'll see how far we get with it. But yeah, this was a game that I played a while back, and it has so many Nancy Drew vibes. So I'm excited that I got the opportunity to play this and to give it a shot. And yeah, it's a lot of fun. Anyway, for those of you that are here, thanks so much for being here. And yeah, I hope you all have a fantastic evening. I don't know if I'm going to do a variety like community stream tonight. I may or may not do like some ARMS Splatoon. We'll see. But for those of you that are here, thanks for watching. And yeah, tune in tomorrow night for some Nancy Drew, the final scene. We'll figure out the culprits. Who did it? Hope you all have a fantastic evening, though. And until next time, I'm going to go ahead and end stream if I can from my phone. Can I end stream my phone? Maybe I can't. As y'all watch me just struggle over here. And I think I saved. I think I did. I'll just do it from here. All right. Good night, everybody.